Hello, welcome to Astronaut. Today we're taking a step closer to home. Basically, as close as we can get while still being outside of Earth. Today we are talking about the moon, its rotation, and its phases. Now, you may be thinking, the moon's phases? I learned about that in elementary school. But don't worry, I promise this will be more in-depth than carving frosting out of an Oreo. You may have heard before that there is a rabbit or a man in the moon. It's a game we play. Similar to finding shapes in the clouds, we can find shapes in the structure of the moon. But unlike clouds, which are always changing form, the moon's structure is pretty much the same no matter when you look at it. Whichever night you choose to look at the moon, you can be sure to find the same figures. Why? Because we always see the same side of the moon facing towards us. So if we always see the same face of the moon, does the moon rotate? Well, if the moon didn't rotate, we would expect to see a different side of the moon every day as the moon travels around Earth. But this does not happen, so the answer is yes. The moon rotates at exactly the same speed as it orbits Earth. Because of this, we always see the same side of the moon. Is this synchronous rotation just a fascinating coincidence? No, this happens because of something called tidal friction. The Earth's tidal bulge tugs on the moon, pulling it along in its orbit, while the moon pulls back on Earth's tidal bulge, slowing it down. This gravitational pull between the Earth and the moon has been going on for so long that they have become locked into a synchronized orbit. The moon is, we say, tidally locked with Earth. Does everyone on Earth see the same side of the moon? Well, yes, but we see it a bit differently. The northern and southern hemispheres' moons are flipped. This is because our perspective of the top and bottom of the moon depends on where we are located. Someone in the northern hemisphere will perceive the top and bottom of the moon as the reverse of the top and bottom seen in the southern hemisphere. We also see the moon's phases differently. And again, the difference is that the moon is flipped. The phases that appear on the right side of the moon in the northern hemisphere appear on the left in the southern hemisphere. Starting with the new moon, the phases in both hemispheres go from waxing crescent to first quarter to waxing gibbous to full moon to waning gibbous to third quarter to waning crescent and then back to new moon. At the equator, the waxing crescent appears as an N, and the phases will appear horizontally rather than vertically. Now, the phases that I previously mentioned are a bit exaggerated. More accurately, these are the phases seen at the north and south poles. But most people live somewhere in between the poles and the equator, so in the northern hemisphere, you are more likely to see something that looks like this. And in the southern hemisphere, you are more likely to see something that looks like this. The closer you are to the poles, the more upright your moon phases will appear. How do these phases happen in the first place? No matter where the moon is in its revolution around the Earth, the sun always lights up half of the moon. Similarly, the sun will always shine on half of Earth. We see phases due to our perspective of the sunlight on the moon at any given time. When the moon is in between the Earth and the sunlit side of the moon is facing away from us. Thus, we have a dark new moon. As the moon begins to move around Earth, we start to see a sliver of light. The amount of sunlight we see on the moon grows more and more until the moon and sun are on opposite sides of Earth. At this point, we see a full moon. As the moon goes on, we begin to see less and less of the sunlight. We call these waning phases of the moon because the word waning suggests a decrease in something, in this case, a decrease in light. From our perspective, the moon loses more and more light until it arrives at a new moon yet again. It takes 29.5 days for the moon to complete its phases. This means it takes about 7.4 days to go from the new moon phase to the first quarter, 14.8 days to go from the new moon to the full moon, and 29.5 days to complete the full cycle. The cycle is slightly different from the moon's 27.3 day revolution around Earth. The lunar cycle is longer than the moon's revolution around Earth because, as the moon travels around Earth, Earth also travels around the sun. This means the moon has to travel a little farther to get back to its original spot in between the Earth and sun. That's pretty much all for today, so thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something new and interesting about the moon. Until next time, ponder, wander, and go right in the stars. I feel